Hi everyone. Today we are going to learn about the parts of speech. First of all, the parts of speech is nothing but the words in English language can be grouped into 8 based on the job they do in a sentence. We can't say this word belongs to this parts of speech because its jobs may change. Some words may do a multiple job at a time, like our father or our mother too. A mother could be a teacher, a driver, or nurse when you are sick, or the chef we know. Parts of speech is nothing but a name given to a word based on its job in a sentence. There are 8 parts of speech. They are noun, pronoun, adjective, verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction, and interjection. First, we will see what is noun. Noun is the name of any person, place, or thing. In short, it's a naming word. For example, a person, name of a person, Shetty, Nisha, or etc. Name of a place, for example, Vilupuram, Chennai, Kadalur, so on so. Then things. Things comes book, pen, pencil, eraser, pencil box, bag, and so on so. Animals. Animals means a lion, tiger, elephant, giraffe, buffalo, etc. It could be a name of any person, place, thing, or animal. Then comes the second type of parts of speech, that is pronoun. Pronoun is nothing but a for noun, which means the word which is used for a noun. Pronoun is the word which replaces a noun. The pronoun is a word which is used instead of a noun. For example, when I introduce myself, hi, I am Divya, or my name is, the word I and my are pronoun here. Some of the pronouns are I, she, he, it, they, we, you, us, myself, theirs, etc. Then comes the third part of speech, that is adjective. Adjective will describe the quality of a person, place, animal, or thing. In short, it describes a noun. Even more clear, adjective gives information about the noun. For example, Rohan is a smart boy. Here, the word smart gives more information about the person, Rohan. Then it is a adjective. Then comes the second example. This is a big hall. The word big gives more information about the place, which is a hall, then it is an adjective. Then comes the fourth type of parts of speech, that is verb. When I tell you the most important part of speech is the verb. We can't even frame a sentence without a verb. Even we can frame a sentence without a noun and a pronoun. But we can't do anything without a verb. What is mean by a verb, first of all? Verbs are words that shows an action or state of being. For example, the baby is crying. Here, the word crying denotes the action of the baby, which means what the baby is doing. Then comes the second example. Raju was eating a biscuit. Here, the word eating refers to his action, that is Raju's action. Then it is called a verb. Then comes the fifth type of parts of speech, that is adverb. Adverb describes the quality of a verb, or it gives more information about a verb or an adjective. For example, my dog eats slowly. When he is hungry, he eats quickly. Here, the word slowly tells us about how the action takes place or how the dog eats. Here, the action is eating. Then it is an adjective. This slowly gives more information. It adds more information about how the dog eats. So, it is an adverb here. Then comes the sixth part of speech, which is a preposition. From the word preposition itself, we can understand it denotes something about the position of a thing. For example, preposition is the parts of speech that shows location, position, time, or direction. For example, we went to school on Monday. Here, the word to tells us the location where we are going. And on tells us the time when the action takes place. Then comes the second example. The train is passing through the tunnel. Here the word through tells us the direction of the train, where it is going. Then comes the seventh part of speech, which is conjunction. A word which joins two sentences or two words are called conjunction. For example, and, but, it, so, that, because, and so on so. I like cats and dogs. Here in this sentence, and is used to join the word cats and dogs. Then comes the second example. The sky is cloudy, but it is not raining. Here, the word but is used to join two sentences. Then it is in conjunction. Then comes the last part of parts of speech, which is interjection. Interjection shows emotion, surprise, or emphasizes. And it always ends with an exclamation mark. For example, ouch, that hurts. In this sentence, ouch is an interjection, which shows a sudden emotion of getting hurt. Then comes the second example. Hi, how are you? Here in the sentence, hi shows a sudden surprise or a sudden emotion which comes out of seeing someone after a long gap. Then it is an interjection. Some of the interjections are ouch, hooray, bravo, alas, and so on. These are the commonly used interjections. Okay, thank you for watching.